or I'll never work for them again. They can't even return a fucking phone call and they want to give me this kind of grief. And I didn't charge them for the second pickup session when in fact they clearly told me not to read the one section that I didn't read and then they changed their mind. No, I'm not going to play this game. We'll be lucky if I don't rescind the whole deal and still make them pay. I will send a cease and desist today if we're not paid before 5. I'm not apologizing when the president of the company nor his assistant can return calls for 2 weeks. And you can let her know that. And you can copy them on it. And let them know that I'm upset that I've been ill and I've gone the extra mile more than once with bad copy that was sent the first time telling me not to re-highlight and stuff. And now, them bitching because I read it finally because they changed their mind. They should have notified me within 24 hours if there's something wrong with the tracks. Normally, I charge a full session to recut. I didn't do that either. So this grief from them is going to stop.
Why don't we just call her and tell her?
You can if you want, but I'm not going to talk to her. But you can take it up with her. Please do. But we're going to be paid today or they're getting a cease and desist. And they're going to learn to return calls or I'm not ever working with them again. They both owe me a phone call today if they ever want to work with me again. And you can tell her that. I'm not wiggling. Not when I'm working on multi... She doesn't even know about the network shit, so you should let her know.
She said also Christina was...
I don't even want to hear it anymore. Please, stop giving me more of that negative bullshit. I don't want to hear it. I want to be paid. I did my work. More than once for them. 3 times now. And I only charged them 1 session.
Hi, can I please speak with Lynn? This is Raven for Kirk Kelly.
Okay. That's for you. Okay. Then that's for you for later. Or do you want me to put it away?
Not right now.
I'll put it away. Shoot going on right here, Johnny. Huh? Check out the shoot.
Yep.
So, John, I need some photos and bio from you that we can put up on the site. What I'd like to do is put you up in About Us as like a producer, director, actor guy. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
And I'll also get you to sign the white label paperwork.
It's like clear up from your
4 or 5 documents that are like
so
anywhere from 4 to 10 pages.
One session. He didn't charge for the pickup lines that he did.
The invoice
was sent over a month ago. Payment was supposed to be received before the job was done.
That's the way we've always done it with everybody. Raven will get you the materials. Here it is right here, John, what it looks like in the daylight. Mitchell, whatever the name of that street is.
You want me to send you some pictures?
Yeah, like a good clean headshot, obviously, that I can put you in the package to J.P. Morgan, because I'd like to put you into that package. I know Vincius Marcus Mercado is going to go up on our site and a few other producers. I'm trying to put, like, you know, a half a dozen... producers or a dozen good producers in the pool that can work on different projects. It's on the invoice.
On the invoice.
That's the way they've always paid. They pay before tracks are released. That's the way we've always done it. They know that.
And also, he's been trying to get a phone call from
the president and our boss.
And
Andy. And
Andrew.
2 weeks.
For 2 weeks.
No one's returning calls. Multiple calls.
Without anyone returning the
cell phone and office.
And not only that, but also on Friday, I talked to Christina myself, and I let her know that he was expecting payment, and then on Monday, it wasn't in there. So I didn't feel like we needed to go out of our way to do that again.
Since we've sent it multiple times. No, but... Yes, she did. It never bounced back and went to their office, to billing, like they always told me.
It never bounced back. It went to their billing department.
Like she told me twice. And nor have they bothered to call in and talk to you about it.
she was going to send it on to the billing department.
Too late. It was supposed to be paid first, and that's not how she told me to direct it. She always said send it to billing direct.
Well, so she changed the rules. Billing, so if she changed it, that's on her.
She didn't let us know.
She didn't let us know to change that.
That's and she was copied on me. We were sending copies of it to her and Andrew. Listen, they either pay before 5 or I don't work for them ever again. That simple. And they return call before 5. Bottom line it for it right now. Don't waste time. Please.
Where did the $600 come from?
I'm not looking at the invoice. You have to look at the invoice and tell me the detail. I've asked you to do that. I don't know. I'm not looking at an invoice. I'm driving. Or have Lynn look at it. She's got it in front of her. Tell her what the detail is. She was copied on it also at the same time. She's copying on every invoice.
I sent a picture of a screenshot in the email that had both dates on there of when it had been sent.
In addition to email forwards. You want to be, put dropped by the Beverly Center or on Robertson, John? La Cienega or Robertson?
Yeah, La Cienega, Beverly Center.
Okay. Or is there a train station down in this area that's better for you?
Where are we?
This is and originally tell her Megan. One second, Megan told me not to read the yellow. Originally, Megan insisted that the yellow was not to be read. That's why it wasn't read the first time.
That was also if they had problems with.
They should have let me know in 24 hours. I was available. They didn't let us know until a week later.
But they did.
No, they did not. No, they let us know a week later. Go look at the records.
Like a week later.
They're supposed to notify me in 24 hours. It's in the contract. It's in the contract to them. They know that. 24 hours. Otherwise, it becomes a charge.
It's in the contract to Intertech.
Tomorrow morning, the sexiest man alive.
I'm saying what contract?
Read the notes that are at the bottom left in the actual invoice.
Read the notes at the bottom left of the actual invoice.
It's in the left side. It gives terms and conditions. The terms and conditions. I'll have to read the line items to you so I can know what it is. I don't know the line items. What are the line items? Does she have it in front of her?
Are you pulling it up?
Oh my God. If I were you, I'd say I have to go. Again, stop arguing
okay.
about it.
I can't argue.
Payment at 5 or we send cease and desist. Or you'll call them. You'll call the client. Oh my God.
I'm sure you were CC'd on it.
She was. Yes, she was. She was CC'd.
Well, but I'm sure you're on it. Yeah,
oh my God. Why is Lynn making this such a big deal? It's a fucking $500 job that's gone awry.
I think because she was the person that's been dealing with this person.
Right,
she
but it's my like account that I brought into her. It's not her account, and she's not going to tell me when I'm going to be paid on my account. The terms and conditions are published. So they've always known them. They're playing with it, and I'm not going to allow it.
Message.
From who?
Are you available to talk or meet up today?
It'll tell you at the top.
It's not. It doesn't. It just says a number. What? I sent you and Maria my reel and resume. She didn't know at Adobe event.
I don't need to hear all of this. If you don't know who it is, you can always call them. It's obviously something that should have been databased if she's Maria got it and it never got databased. I have no idea what it is, but I don't want to focus on that right now. I need you to stay focused or I don't want to hear another dime about money to the rest of the day. If you're not going to focus right now, okay, stop all distractions. Text everything. Because once we walk into the doctor's office, you can't be doing this. That's why I kept saying, get off the phone with her. She's just.
Am I supposed to find this in PayPal?
I want
it
in PayPal. You need to open the invoice and tell me the detail. Stop making me guess. I've been begging to hear what the detailed items are. very stressful having people keep pushing on the same shit when I already know we did it right the first time. If there's a problem, she can take it up with Megan. In fact, tell her next time she says there's any problems, tell her to call Megan and have Megan fix it. Because Megan clearly told me, do not read the yellow part, they don't want that. I have no idea why, that's what the directions were. So I didn't. Then they take a week to get back and notify me? No. They're lucky I didn't charge them for a second session. Or the third. Now they're pushing it. If three times isn't enough and they can't pay a bill, then fuck it. Don't use the project and you'll still pay. After all, it is my IP. Wow, what's going on here? They got it shut right down. Whoa. Oh, shit. Big accident. Damn. How you doing, Johnny?
Huh?
Yeah, how you doing?
I'm trying to find it.
Are you in PayPal?
I'm in PayPal.
Go to unpaid, yeah.
And
just scroll down and look around October 14th, I think it was.
Why aren't these
not? I don't know. Sorry. And it was, I think Andrew's name, Andrew shows up for the billing. Email address. Andrew, whatever his last name is, the Russian guy. Correct. Yep, I know.
October 14th.
Yeah, I think it was around the 14th, wasn't it?
Sounds right.
Well, yeah, because it's over a month, yeah. Today's the 17th, 18th. 17th or 18th? John, is today the 17th or 18th, do you know?
The total is $620.75.
I need the breakdown.
Which includes the $75 Hamilton fee.
All right, that was the fee I was told to build in. She said she gets 15%. She doesn't get 15% of my 500. She gets 15% on top of my 500. So that's her fee. Why is she bitching?
And BankWire.
BankWire doesn't have a charge. There's zero behind BankWire. Correct?
It says
6.9%, but what's the number in the column over there? Zero.
For the transaction fees?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
BankWire is $75, amount zero.
Right, if they send it via BankWire, it's $75. So yeah, the total cost is PayPal fees of 500 hers. So just call her back and say, what's the problem here? And who's it sent to?
It's to Andrew Christie, billing at Intertech.
Anybody else? Who was CC'd? Who are the CCs? You'll have to go into edit to see the CCs.
Okay.
Edit it. And if Lynn's not in there, add her. If Bill's not in there, add him. If Christine's not in there or Andrew, add them all in and resend it one last time.
Yeah, she wasn't CC'd.
Who wasn't?
Nobody. It looks like she's billing.
Okay, well then put it all in. But I think they were. I think when you send this and open it up, you'll see there's several others that were pre-existing. Because I don't know if the... All right, so you want Christina? You may have to go into the database to find them. It may not be in there. Mm-hmm. Do you need it?
I think I got it.
Okay.
So, it popped up.
Okay, so Christina.
Yeah.
Is it Intratech or whatever the company's name? Okay, and then Andrew. And then put in Lynn.
Oh, wait, no, that's not right. I'm sorry.
And then put in Lynn yourself. And Bill. And then resend it again and call her and say, you know what? I don't know what everybody's complaining about. He put in the 15% that you asked for. If you don't want it, we can take that out. If you want to lose your commission.
Send it to Lynn right now?
And send it to all? All right, fine, and have her forward it.
Yeah.
And then I would then just send an email and say, make sure this is paid by five. The money has, if you look, your percentage of 15%, which you said, which is not coming out of the 500. I told everybody it has to be in addition to. They're not going to try and backtrack now and take out and give me 4.25 for a job they made me do three times. Fuck off. Or she can waive her fee if she wants. I'm not lowering mine. My base is my base. I told her nothing under 4x scale, and she still brought this in at scale.